Iran's presidential election polls are closed after 15 hours of voting. Iranians had waited in line for hours in scorching heat at some polling stations in downtown Tehran and other cities, casting ballots across the vast country from desert outposts to Gulf seaports and nomad pastures. Voting was extended by 5 hours to meet demand, but also as possible political stagecraft to showcase the participation of voters. All six candidates have signed a statement calling for no gatherings until official results are announced tomorrow morning. And now here's the rest of your World in a Minute. Leaker Edward Snowden launched new allegations against the NSA today, and he's reached hero status in the eye of many Chinese citizens because of that. He told the South China Morning Post the intelligence agency launched illegal attacks on civilian computers in China. Well, records handed to the paper showed specific dates and IP addresses targeted since 2009. This comes after Snowden alleged Chinese public officials, businesses, and Chinese university, which hosts Hong Kong's main server, were all targets. The Airbus A350 has taken off on its maiden flight, setting the stage for intensifying competition with U.S. rival Boeing in the long-haul, wide-body aircraft market. Today's flight was to last about 4 hours and marked a key step on the path to full certification. More than half of the A350 is made up of lightweight carbon fiber designed to save on jet fuel, which makes up half of the cost of long-haul flights. President Obama is scheduled to visit Africa later this month. Now, the cost of that trip is coming into question. The 8-day trip to Africa is expected to cost up to $100 million. The entire first family is accompanying the president, along with hundreds of agents and 56 support vehicles, including 14 limos and 3 trucks full of bulletproof glass to protect them. There's also an aircraft carrier with fully staffed emergency medical center that will be on standby off the coast, with fighter jets ready for protection. Critics say this 3-country trip to South Africa, Senegal, and Tanzania is far too expensive, especially during the sequester, with many agencies making across-the-board spending cuts. And that's your World in a Minute.